believe any of you got out of there alive.
What were you doing? It sounds like you were playing Rambo, and you didn't even tell me a thing about it.
Well, it all happened so fast, before I knew it, I was, you know, knee-deep in this action.
Oh. All right, we know that Grace is stable. What about Ellen and Dr. Harmon?
They're a little shaky, but who wouldn't be?
Maybe I should see if there's anything I can do.
Well, that's a good idea, but right now we got to prepare for the DA's on her way over here.
Could you not bring that up? Let's not talk about it. Don't remind me, Lucy.
You don't have to be nervous. She just wants to ask a few questions.
Oh. Yes, we're just going to explain that the shipments of the Orient de-stress that Rex had tampered with him. It's very simple.
Everybody's going to believe me, just like they believe that you didn't kidnap Serena, right? I don't think so.
Come on, this is different.
Yeah, it's different. You happen to be sort of a respected attorney. I'm a convicted perjurer.
All those people have left?
Yeah, the reporters finally got tired of waiting for Lucy to come back out.
Hi.
Hi, who are you?
Oh, Victor, this is, Scott Baldwin. He's Lucy's attorney.
Hello, Dr. Collins. I've heard a lot about you.
Why does Lucy need an... This has something to do with that, Rex Stanton business.
How did you know about that?
Well, it's been in the newspapers for weeks. I can't read, you know. Tell me about your troubles.
Troubles? My troubles? I don't have any troubles. Besides the fact that I'm still a little shaky after being poisoned and they've taken all my money. I don't really have a dime to my name. I'll probably lose all that. And my reputation is in shreds. Again. And perhaps they're going to send me up the river soon, you know, to the big house. But, hey, you know what? Come to think of it, jail might not be such a bad idea. Kind of a regular vacation after everything I've been through. But thank you for asking.
Listen, you don't have to cook dinner.
Well, I want to.
Yeah, but you just got done working at the hospital.
Well, cooking isn't work. I love to mess around in the kitchen.
All right. Ooh, as you can see, it's a mess, so yeah. I wasn't expecting any company.
Oh, so now I meet the real you. It's okay. You're a doctor. You can't trouble yourself with dirty coffee cups. No, dirty plates to match.
Well, I eat a lot of takeout.
Then you are going to inhale what I dish out. In fact, I guarantee you'll never forget it.
The surgeons did the best they could to repair Bobby's carotid artery.
Did they do any EEG?
No, but they'll do one if he doesn't wake up soon. He lost a tremendous amount of blood.
I'd like to be alone with my brother, please. You got me first. I'm not weak, Bobby. Maybe this will prove that to you.
All it proves is that one night you were faster than me.
You're not gonna let this go, are you?
Huh? I'm not a wuss.
We're brothers. Why do we keep doing this to each other?
You're not my brother.
Oh, yes. Yes, I am your brother. I'm your brother, and you shot me anyway.
You were gonna testify against me.
That's not true.
You're a liar. You met with the feds.
No, they contacted me, Bob. I wasn't going to tell him anything.
You helped put me in prison.
After you tried to kill me? I mean, what kind of choice are you giving me?
You could have been one of us.
Never.
You still think you're better than me?
I don't pass judgment on people, Bob.
I would drop the quest for sainthood. You ate my guts.
At first I did. But not now. Hate is a wasted emotion, Bob.
Sure you hate me. I can walk.
than you can.
So what?
You'll never forgive me.
You know, I have more freedom in my life than you've ever had as a Mancusi, ever.
You're a Mancusi.
Not anymore.
Yes, you are. You're a Mancusi. You can call yourself anything you want and try and pass, but you're a Mancusi and so am I. This is not over.
Hey, room 620's calling for a bedpan.
Get it yourself.
How you feeling?
Well, I'd feel better if the guy had missed. But I'm doing okay. Listen, thanks for hot-footing me to the hospital.
Sorry about the potholes.
Ouch.
I'll go around them next time.
There won't be a next time.
How's the patient?
Oh, complaining of a storm.
Yeah, I heard about this one. Everyone is worried sick about you.
They don't have to be. I'm gonna be fine. I'm not gonna let something as stupid as a bullet stop me.
How's the pain?
Manageable. Thank God for the PCA machine. It just makes me really sleepy.
You should rest then. Frank, stop flirting and let her sleep.
Oh, come on, do I have to?
Yes.
You guys are too much.
I think she'll be all right.
That's a huge relief.
Unlike Lark, when I get my hands on her. Have you seen her?
No. I thought you were meeting her at the nurse's station on 6.
Well, I saw her there, but she said she had to take care of a patient. I told her to help the patient and meet me at the car. Haven't seen her since. I paged her over the hospital system, but she didn't answer.
This is my headache. I'll take care of it.
Well, when you find her, will you please tell her that I have better things to do with my time than play hide and seek?
Okay, Lark, what the hell are you up to now?
I'm impressed. Sauce from scratch.
Don't be. It's easy. All you need are perfectly ripe tomatoes, and the rest is creativity.
Well, it's not quite as easy as open up a jar.
Oh, if I had a kitchen like yours, I'd always be messing around in it.
Yeah, I suppose you don't get to cook very often in the dorms.
Just over an illegal hot plate. By comparison, you've got it made.
Yeah?
Yeah. You got all your books and all your music. You can do whatever you want, win whatever you want. And when somebody locks that door, and they knock, if you want to pretend you're not home, then they just go away.
So, who taught you how to cook so well?
My mom. She was a chef. We spent a lot of time just goofing around in the kitchen.
That sounds like fun.
It was. And as an added benefit, I'm really good in the kitchen. I'm really good in a lot of other rooms in the house as well.
Hello, Dara.
Hello.
Nice to see you again.
I wish it were under better circumstances.
Yeah. Come on in.
Ah, well. If it isn't Dara, district attorney. So nice to see you. I had no idea that assistant DAs made house calls.
Well, we usually don't, but we've been so swamped with phone calls ever since your pills hit the market, we've been forced to work overtime.
Gee, I'm so sorry for all of you. Dara, do you know Scott Baldwin, my attorney? Oh, yoo-hoo. Scott Baldwin, this is the assistant DA, Dara Jensen. Dara, Scott, Scott, Dara, Scott. Hi.
Hi.
So you're Scott Baldwin.
Come on, you don't believe anything you hear in the DA's office, do you?
Well, if any of it's true, I'm surprised they're still allowing you to practice law.
Tea, Dara, how about some green tea? You know, it's very soothing on the nerves.
Yeah, you can understand if I pass.
The tea is fine. It's just safe. Doc, why don't you drink some of my tea to prove that to Dara?
Sure. Delicious.
I'd like some tea.
Oh, well, thank you, Victor.
Dara, I'd like you to meet my father, Victor Collins.
Hi, it's really nice to meet you.
Pleasure.
There you go. Lucy, let's just dive right in. Whose idea was it to market Orient De-Stress?
was Rex Stanton's idea from beginning to end. He was trying to discredit Miss Coe.
That's true, and the only reason he went after Lucy in the first place is because he believed that she tricked him.
And that wasn't a very nice thing to do.
Okay, I'd rather hear all this from Lucy, gentlemen, if you don't mind. Lucy, why would you agree to market Orient Distress if you knew it was coming from disreputable sources?
Well, honestly, what I was trying to do was get Rex's confidence. I wanted to prove and get evidence that Scott had nothing to do with kidnapping his daughter.
So you agreed to market the pill to impress Stanton and just paid no attention to the content?
Wait a minute. Of course I paid attention to the content. Very close attention. In fact, we made rigorous quality controls.
We have lab reports right here.
Well, obviously the lab didn't do a very good job.
I really resent that, you know, because I take a lot of pride in hiring the best employees, and that chemist of mine, he was the best. He had a wonderful reputation, and we did test it. I think what happened was we tested it, we bottled it, we got it ready to go, and somehow Rex Stanton switched the product before we could get it to the distributor.
Now, if you look at Stanton's record, you'll see that poison is his favorite M.O.
Mr. Stanton's involvement will be investigated, but right now I'm trying to explore the extent to which Lucy is culpable.
I am not culpable.
Under FDA regulations, as well as others, you are responsible for the safety of your product. Now, at the very least, you fell down on a job. Now, in addition to your perjury conviction and your admittance to perjury during your lawyer's trial, your marriage under false pretenses, I would have to say you would not fare very well in a trial.
A trial? I am not going to try.
That's an awfully narrow interpretation of the facts, don't you think?
My client is the victim here.
Tell that to the people who went to the emergency room. I'll be in touch. Good night, all.
Yeah, right. Good night to you. It's not a good night.
It's nice meeting you.
Good nightmare. That's what I'm having, a good nightmare. Such a disaster.
All right, Lucy. Lucy, deep breath. Slow down. You're just going to hyperventilate.
No, I'm fine. It's okay. Don't worry about me. I'm just going through total, complete hysteria.
I know.
Come on, Lucy. Just take it easy. The DA's office is on a fishing expedition. They haven't got anything to charge you with.
Right, okay. You tell me that I'm not going to jail. Can you guarantee me that?
Well, absolutes in life.
Oh. All right. Hold on. Scott, what if she just settles the class action suit?
Well, I'm sure the DA's office would, you know, look favorably on goodwill.
Well, what have you been doing? Have you been able to find where Rex stashed my money?
All of our leads have been dead ends.
I can help you find that.
Oh, Victor, that is so sweet, but no. Thank you very much for your offer. Maybe later. Okay, guys, I'm going to see it this way. Sometimes you just got to cut and run, right? Cut your losses, and that's what I'm going to do. How much will it cost me to settle this myself?
Well, Jack's cosmetics and your personal accounts would be gone. You would be wiped out, Lucy.
All right. Easy. Breathe. Yeah. Hey,
have you seen Lark?
No, but somebody just paged her.
No, that was me. She was supposed to ride home with Julie after a shift, but she never showed up.
Really? Lark did something she wasn't supposed to do. That's shocking, Frank. You know, her lack of respect is infuriating.
I was angry at first, but nobody has seen it for hours. I'm starting to get worried. I'm going to call security.
This is Dr. Harmon. Who am I speaking to, please? Dave, you know, with the ponytail?
Yeah.
Listen, this is my brother we're talking about, okay? I need those tests. Fine. Why don't I just come down myself and run them, okay? You people are useless.
Lab backed up, huh?
The lab is full of morons.
No, you don't have to tell me. Listen, it's good to see you in one piece.
Well, it's not easy being grateful, considering Grace. And my brother?
He's the one that's been chasing you?
It's very complicated, Joe. Can't get into it.
Older brothers can be the worst.
We just have to take what life dishes out sometimes.
Hey, come on. Was I that bad?
As much as you irritate me, I could never imagine pulling a gun on you.
So tell me the truth. Was that the best spaghetti you've ever had?
I'll have to admit, it was quite excellent. You know, you really are a great cook.
Thank you.
Oh, what are you doing? No. I will get to this some other time.
Next week?
Maybe tomorrow.
So, who's the blonde?
It's someone that I used to date.
Used to?
We weren't together very long.
I just broke up too. He was older. No way it would have worked out. He was a teacher. Nice guy, but way too bossy and boring. He didn't even want me to see my friends.
So you dumped him?
It was really hard to shake him, but I think he got the message.
I can understand. It'd be hard to let go of a woman like you.
Okay, I'm fishing for compliments. Like me? How?
Beautiful. Intelligent. Creative. That's a lot to let go of.
Well, I'm glad I broke up with him. Otherwise, I wouldn't be here with you now.
Human. Wish to God you were my brother.
You're stuck with me, Eric. You're a mancoosie. You can't get away from me.
Respiratory arrest! Respiratory arrest from 1007!
Lucy, you don't have to pawn your lovely things. I can help you.
Dr. Collins, we're going to, you know, a bit more money than you got socked away.
Please call me Victor, and the point is not how much I may have socked away.
No, the point is how frustrating this is that we know Rex has millions somewhere. We just can't find one red cent.
I can find it.
Victor, it's getting late. Wouldn't you like to turn in?
Monk, stop hovering.
I'm going to get you out of this mess. It was you helping Serena and me is what caused all this trouble.
I keep telling you, Scott, it's okay. I love Serena, and I even like you sometimes. And this doesn't matter. This I did with no regrets, okay?
Well, Serena's money is in locked up in her trust fund, but I have money of my own that you are welcome to. All right? And, you know, if you feel funny about that, Lucy, then you could make me like a junior partner in the Jack's company, you know? So it's not like charity. You know, we've been in partnership before. Deception, we ran that pretty well.
Okay.
What do you think about that?
I said I'd do it. Thank you.
Yes, just like that? That easy?
Yeah, just like that. End of argument. You have a deal. I'll do it.
Well, since you're in the mood to accept help, I've got some money I can kick in.
Fine, I will take your money. Of course, you better keep in mind that I've grown accustomed to living in this style. You have to keep me in it.
Well, actually, the thought of you and Scott being partners again kind of boggles the mind, but whatever works.
Hey, you. Thank you. I really appreciate this, pal.
My pleasure, Lucy.
Any sign of the wayward youth?
No.
She's probably somewhere hanging out with her friends. She did try to get out of being punished.
I'm worried.
That's exactly what she wants.
She wouldn't deliberately worry me.
Lark will do whatever she has to do to be the center of your attention.
Lark is clear on where she and I stand.
That doesn't mean she has to like it. You know, she is trying to provoke you one way or another, and you're feeding the situation by playing the doting dad.
I am not stupid. I know Lark is scared and she's acting out, and sometimes she can be a real pain in the butt, but all of that doesn't negate the fact that she needs someone to look out for her.
This is female manipulation 101. When in doubt, appeal to a man's protective nature.
Lark is missing, and I'm right to be worried.
Sure. Sure you are. Wait a minute.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm taking things too fast. I'm sorry.
No, don't apologize. I'm just gonna make it a little easier for you.
You are so beautiful.
So show me how you feel about me. I have condoms in my purse.
Mm.
He was totally obstructed from the bleeding into his neck. We just couldn't ventilate him. I'm sorry.
He said it would be him or me.
This was not your fault.
He always wanted to make me into a killer.
Tonight, Mike really loves his little sister-in-law and his best friend, but that doesn't mean he'll like them dating. It's an all-new That's Life, ABC Tonight. To find out more about All My Children, visit abc.com.